Hi everyone, my name is Thomas King from the Center for Innovation in Learning and Teaching. This video will take you through how to build lessons pages in Vula and how to design nice, simple, and straightforward learning pathways for your content. So for those of you who don't use Vula very often, a very good tool within Vula is the lessons tool. And I'm going to take you through how to use lessons most effectively, combining standard Vula features together in an organized learning pathway that your students can follow, hopefully without having to ask you too many questions. So I've created a little demonstration site here. The site is public. Anyone can search for it and add yourselves to it. And I'll be referring to materials on the site for the rest of this presentation. I'm going to start with a bit of an overview. So as mentioned, the site will demonstrate only basic Vula features. So you don't have to use anything complicated or external tools, anything like that. I'll be looking at primarily the lessons tools using over here the following topics. So let's get started. On the left, you'll see I've created some lessons pages. How to do that is you go to Site Setup, Manage Tools, scroll down until you get to the lessons thing, click Lessons, keep scrolling down, continue, and then you add however many lessons pages you want. Let's just add one for now. You can add as many others as you want, and you can have as many lessons as you need. Once you've got that, you just click Finish to create. And where it is, it'll add it at the bottom of your screen on the left. You can use the Organize tools to rearrange the various things. So we could move this up to the top or put it in the middle, wherever you want to go. I'm going to leave it at the bottom because I've already created some pages for us. So, assuming your course has modular content, so you have a number of modules, you can organize your lessons pages according to said modules. Here's an example. So in module one, we've got some various elements on the page to help our learners navigate the content. We advise that you start with something called instructional text. Instructional text helps guide the learners through a learning experience. This could contain the basic outline of the module, contain the activities that their students are expected to do, some information on core concepts, etc., etc. A couple of paragraphs is usually sufficient. I've left, obviously, the instructional text blank. You'll have to create your own. Underneath that, I just added a small section of extra text about information the students can follow. For instance, there's a course information page, which has various information on it, and a chat room. And I've linked to that course information page with a hyperlink here. And you'll see this takes me to a course information page where I've included things like the DP requirements for the course, some due dates, the late submissions policy, and so on and so on. Heading back to modules, I'll quickly show you how I did that. Over here, this is a text box, so we're going to edit our text box, scroll down, and this time I'm going to link to the chat room. You right-click, say copy link location, this is in Firefox, select our text, add, and paste the information. Now I've created a hyperlink to my chat room so students reading this can go straight into the chat room feature. And I've described how I'm going to use the chat room over here. Please note, don't put in tools that you don't intend to use. So things like chat room, only include a chat room in your course if you intend to check it regularly. Could be every 6 hours, could be every day, could be once a week, whatever works for you. Right. The next section of your instructional text is learning objectives. We strongly recommend that you add a number of learning objectives so that your students know what they should be getting out of the course or particular module. They can be as extensive or as sparse as you like, but it does help students follow the learning pathway and, on reflection of this module, see what they should have learned. All right, so we've got the instructional text out the way. Now I've got some information on the activities of this lesson. So in this module, we're going to be required to complete these tasks. Watch a video, read through some articles, post in a forum, complete an MCQ, and write a short reflective essay assignment. Now you see I started creating some basic links to the learning materials down here, and now I'm going to show you how to add the content. So we want to start them off with a video. And I've got a video in mind, so I'm going to head over to YouTube. I'm going to search for the video in question when it loads. This is just a video that I happen to know about. And I want my students to view this video before continuing. So, how do I do that? Back on my page, I click at the bottom. This is how you add new content. I'm going to, embed content on the page. This is how you would add images and video content most easily in Vula. So I click embed content. I need to get the embed code for the video. How do you do that on YouTube? You go here, you click, share, embed, and we copy that embed code, the whole thing, without any alterations. Back on the other side, we're going to paste it in there. And there we've got our video. We save. And now inside our material, we've got an embedded video. Now you'll notice that these are two different content sections. So now I want to add a new section with the two core readings of the course. So I'm going to add, some text. I'm going to indicate these are the core readings. And I'm just going to italicize this for some fun. Save. And now I'm going to add some more content. I'm going to add content links. Now I've already added these to my resources folder. So I'm going to select my existing files, module 1 resources, and I'm going to select my own little reading there and continue. And there's a link to the PDF. Students click on this, and it's going to open the information that they need. I said two content readings, so I'm going to add a second one. Add content links, select files from resources, module 1, and I click the wrong button. You need to click select and not the link itself. Sorry. Continue, and done. Now I've got my core readings. Now I've got a supplementary reading as well. So once again, I'm going to add a little text thing to indicate this is supplementary. I'm going to italicize it. And save. Add another content link. There we go. Following the normal pathway. And I'm going to select Ursula Le Guin. Very nice novel. All right. So now, in my learning materials, I've indicated that there was a video. There were two core readings and one supplementary reading. Here's my video. Here are my core readings. And here's my supplementary reading. My learning materials are now all inside the page without having to send people to the resources folder. They can all read it directly on the lessons page itself. Now, in my activities, I said students would have to watch a video and read through the articles, and they would have three activities. Let's add those activities now. So as before, I'm just going to label the content as learning activities. It could be called assessment activities, it could be called activities, whatever you want it to be called. And I'm just going to use a heading 2 for that. And what do we say? We're going to put a forum, a quiz, and a link to an essay. So let's add those. I'm going to start with a forum, link to a form or a topic. There I've created this forum for this topic for this particular lesson. You select an item. And there's my link to modules. I said also that I'm going to add a quiz, so link to a test or quiz. And there's my module 1 quiz. There we go. And lastly, I said I'm going to link to an assignment. Select a link to assignment, and there's my assignment. So you see, using only Vula native tools and one YouTube video, I've created a learning pathway for my students so they can navigate through Module 1 by following all the information that they need will be on this page. As they read through it, they'll have an understanding of what the course is about or what the module is about, where to find help information, what they should be learning from this course, what they should be doing, what materials they should be accessing, and what activities they should be completing in order to complete the course. Now, this works if you have a module which is a contained unit, you know, a month long, a week long, or whatever. But if your modules are divided into separate lessons, you might want to look at a different mechanism. So we're going to end this video by showing you how to create multiple sub-pages linking to specific lessons all under a same module. So we're going to navigate to module 2 on the left here. And you'll see this module is divided into weekly lessons. And you can access the various content in each of these. Now these are blank, there's nothing in them currently. I'm just going to show you how to set up these links. These are sub-pages. So when we add new content, we want to add a sub-page to the lesson. Click there. And we're going to just call it week 3 topic. And then of course the topic is whatever that weekly content is based on. Now, I like buttons, so instead of calling it just a link, I'm going to show as a button. You don't have to do that. In fact, I'm going to untick and show you what it looks like. See, now this is just another lessons page. Navigate back to module 2. Got lesson 1 and 2 as buttons, and lesson 3 as just a link. They all take you to just another lessons page. So this is purely a cosmetic difference on the side here. All right. Thank you very much for listening. We'll be releasing more videos on various other features of Woola as the week continues.